everybody out there in YouTube land. This is Jen, and Christian is with me. And tonight we are talking Chucky, episode 7, Twice the Grieving, Double the Loss. What'd you think?
It's a good episode.
It's a very good episode.
It's kind of, we're starting to see the completion of some character arcs as well as some overarching themes that the series are going for, and I'm liking it. I'm really liking it.
I'm liking it too. A lot has happened in this episode. Kyle and Andy are still on the way.
Well,
kind of.
Specifically,
at least
Andy.
In the beginning of the episode is still on the way. And then Andy makes a decision, and as an audience, I love that this show, we all know why he did it. He wasn't doing it because he was a jerk, or that, you know, mean big strong man, you little woman. It was because Andy, you know, Kyle is one of the only people in his life that he, you know, can still love and care for, and he does not want to put her in any harm's risk. And I think he kind of has a premonition or knows the odds aren't too good.
Totally. Although, I said this when we were watching it. I get it. It's cool. It's kind of a dick move to leave her with no money and no car in the middle of fucking nowhere USA, like fucking 20 states over from where you guys live or something. That was kind of a dick move.
Yeah, it's kind of a dick move, but I guess he also knows that if anyone can handle it, Kyle can.
I suppose so.
Yeah, I have a feeling Kyle's going to catch up to Andy anyway. It's kind of a pointless move. But I guess this could be kind of a controversial thing, because I know some women would go, you know, we don't need that, but I actually
It works for Andy's character.
I think it's sweet. I don't see it as a chauvinistic move. I actually think it's rather sweet. Meanwhile, we also have a funeral to attend to. Multiple funerals to attend to. The one that we open up on is
Junior's mom.
Yeah, is a Junior's mother, and we have Lexi, Devin, and Jake standing in a group, and they're trying to decide what to do. And Jake's like, "Okay, we still got to keep fighting," and Devin's like, "No, we're no good for each other." And he's talking about the group, but he's also
He's also talking about him and Jake's relationship, because he's having trouble getting over his mom's death.
Yeah, and there is a part of him, I think every time he sees Jake, he kind of, compartmentalizes it as to part of, you know, he doesn't blame Jake, I don't think, but deep down, maybe just a little bit, even though he knows, like, it's a heart-head thing. His head knows that it wasn't Jake's fault, but his heart isn't quite so sure, and he thinks the best thing to do would be to break up the band. And Lexi kind of, she's not exactly jumping up and down with enthusiasm, but she reluctantly kind of thinks, yeah, maybe we would be better on our own. And the band breaks up, and in fairness to Devin, he's dealing with a lot. You know, his dad was already dead before the show started. Now his mom's gone, and so he's going to live with an aunt temporarily, but then he's probably going to have to go into foster care. And there's a scene where Jake goes down to the basement to talk to Devin to say, you know, well, we can still be together and all that, and Devin's like, no dice. No dice. But the interesting thing about this episode is later on, Devin is looking through a shoebox of photographs, and he sees one in particular of when he was a little boy and his mom is in uniform, and it kind of changes his mind. At least he decides to fight.
He's in revenge mode now. He's kind of in revenge mode, and he also this episode is everyone deduces, oh, that's where Chucky's hiding out at. It's his old house, which we've known for a few episodes. So Devin heads that way, and Lexi and Jake are beginning to head that way at the end of the episode.
Yes, but speaking of Jake and Lexi, and also Junior, going back to the wake, Junior not only has this problem with the first love of his life saying we're just not good together, he also gets hit figuratively and literally by his cousin Junior, and Junior throws out the accusation, everywhere you go, there's death. You know, your parents, my mom, Devin's mom, you know, it just seems like there's death is following Jake, and it's all his fault. And Junior literally punches Jake's lights out, and Devin saw what comes, and Junior Junior's dad, you know, says, knock it off, lay off. And before, and Jay and Junior starts heading into the house, and who pulls up in her fucking awesome car?
Fucking Tiffany and Jennifer Tilly mode.
And she, now I don't have her bazongas, but she's like in a little dress, kind of like this, with a very low cut dress, and she's just bouncing up there with her boobs, you know, swaying gently in the breeze, as it were.
As tits tend to do.
As tits tend to do. Especially hers. Hers are amazing tits. Jennifer Tilly, just let's say this, people. Jennifer Tilly has amazing tits. And she goes up to Devon Sawa and she kisses him and I'm so sorry for your loss. And the, and she ever so seductively licks a little bit of her upper lip. You know, I mean, it's just as bad as porn as you can get. And a decent amount of porn at a funeral. Yeah. It really is
it's
awesome.
It's one of those things where you're just sitting there going, wait, what? Why is Tiffany here? Assumably, it's just to cause chaos because she is an agent of chaos.
Yeah.
But
much like Harley Quinn.
Yeah, basically. But, like, she's just there to fuck with people. Like, you know, for all the audience knows, like, I'm sure the next episode will probably answer this, but for all we know, Jennifer Tilly was like, oh, there's a funeral in town. I'm gonna go fuck with that. She has no idea the fucking goings-on of, like, Chucky involved with all these characters, because I believe Cult stated that all the Chuckies have individual consciousnesses and don't share one hive consciousness.
Yeah. We hope, anyway. But, and she also gives Devon Sawa some Swedish meatballs.
Yeah, we're back to Swedish meatballs.
Yay!
Okay. And yeah, she gives she gives Junior some Swedish meatballs. Like, this is later in the episode. She drives up to the house, hands him some meatballs, and is like, oh, these are your father's favorites? Which is like, okay, that's probably a weird throwaway line, but like literally the scene before that is a flashback of her and Chucky in the 80s talking about how Swedish meatballs are Chucky's favorite thing. I'm sure that is a weird fucking filler line or something and doesn't mean anything, but huh, Junior, Chucky. Junior, Chucky, huh, there's an idea.
Yeah, there's a lot.
I'm sure that's probably not gonna go anywhere, but if it does, just in case it does, just gonna let you know, I said it here already. Called it, kind of.
And Jennifer Tilly, you go, well, how do you know my dad? Oh, well, you mean he didn't tell? Oh, I've said too much already. It'll be our little secret. I mean, she just is so good.
I'm gonna guess she probably doesn't know Sawa, but like her interaction with Junior, like there's clearly a reason for why she's interacting with Junior, which I imagine is probably she's in cahoots with main series or like this series Chucky doll, as opposed to
I'm going cross-eyed.
Yeah, like that's okay. That's one thing that is gonna be a little bit fucking making this show harder to talk about is ever since Cult, we have the multiple Chucky things. So like main series, we got Fia, we got Nico Chucky, we got this series Chucky doll, and then the end of the episode, that's gonna get a whole lot worse next episode with having to specify which Chucky.
Yeah, it's getting a little convoluted. I love this show, but
that's not a con. I like this show a lot, but it makes it a little difficult to talk about.
It really does, and Devon is still figuring out. Well, he kind of has a change of heart seeing that photograph of his mom, and he decides to go to the house where it all began. And speaking of great acting, Jennifer Tilly's amazing as always, but so is Fiona Dorf, and she is playing Fiona, but vis-a-vis Chucky, if you guys can follow
that. Okay, so remember a couple episodes ago where I was like, oh, this is fucking great, because you have Fiona Dorf playing Nico, playing Chucky? Well, this time we get the inverse. We have Fiona Dorf playing Chucky, playing Nico. It's really fucking good.
She's tied up, and she's telling Devon, oh, she's crazy, meaning Jennifer Tilly and stuff, and Devon, you know, being a sweet kid, you know, he undoes her and gives her water, and then they go, what's your name? And he goes, well, it depends. I have two names, and right now it's Chucky.
Yep.
And boom, and it knocks Devon's lights out, and then you get the big reveal of the just ginormous fucking Chuckster.
We finally, whoa, this episode finally reveals what Chucky's whole plan for this series has been, and especially the reason why he's been so obsessed with getting a child to kill somebody in this town. It's because I'm jumping ahead a little bit. This is the end of the episode reveal, but I might as well talk about it now. It's to fulfill a voodoo curse that basically activates all of the good guy dolls in the town to get possessed by Chucky without him having to do it. Okay, don't know how that fucking works.
It's gonna be explained deeply, I think, in the last episode. Oh, I'm sure.
I'm sure he'll probably pull out another fucking Voodoo for Dummies book.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Honestly, I would be kind of okay with that, sure.
That would be awesome.
But yeah, so that's Chucky's big plan, and you might be going, wait, so does that mean somebody, one of the kids killed somebody?
Yes.
Yeah.
It does, but is it Lexi? No. Is it Jake? No.
Hero. Sarge? No. Rosemary, the telephone operator? No.
Matt Damon.
Could be.
It's Junior.
It's Junior. Oh, by the way, Junior and Chucky. I was right about one thing of Junior and Chucky, Chucky kind of molding Junior into becoming a killer. I was wrong for the reasons why Junior becomes a killer, but I was correct that was going to happen. And Junior kills his dad.
Yeah, Chucky basically eggs him on and also makes him think that his father was having an affair with Jennifer Tilly, even though that probably wasn't the case. And, you know, all the pressure that his dad has put on him. Plus, you know, just losing his mom, there was grief on top of grief. And he's just right. Plus, he just lost his girlfriend. Mm-hmm. I mean, everything that could happen has happened to Junior. You know, his shithead of a cousin that he doesn't particularly likes living with him. I mean, just all hell has gone. All hell's gone to the handbag.
If you look at this show from Junior's perspective, it does kind of suck.
Yeah, it does. And so he decides that, you know, he's had enough. And he kills his Devon Sawa. And Devon Sawa is kind of repeating what his brother did. You know, he's turning to the bottle just like his brother did after his wife died. And he's becoming a drunk. And Junior doesn't like that anyway. And so he uses Chucky, literally, to bash Devon Sawa.
Here's something we've never seen done before. And I'm surprised it took this long. Chucky
is the murder weapon.
Chucky doll is actually used to kill somebody for once. Junior bludgeons Devon Sawa over the head with fucking Chucky, and Chucky's just going, whee!
He's having
a great time. But
yeah,
it's
close-ups.
It's cool to finally see the actual Chucky doll be used to murder somebody. I'm surprised it's taken this long.
And then I just love the end of it where Chucky goes, thank you. You do not know how long it was to get one of you little shits to murder somebody. Yeah. You've got guts, kid.
You got guts, kid. I like you.
Yeah. Yeah, and also we got the beat.
Okay, yeah, because I think we glossed over this in one of the hospital episodes.
Yeah.
It was bugging me, and then they do explain it in the behind the scenes little after the episode thing. Junior just psychs himself up with We Got the Beat, and
he wanted to be a singer.
The actor's motivation reason for that in his head is Junior wanted to be a singer instead of the runner, so he just uses We Got the Beat as a psych him up thing when he was getting knocked out and when he's killing his dad. It's kind of a cool touch. You also get to see him and Chucky singing We Got the Beat for a little bit, and it's hearing Brad Dorff We Got the Beat's kind of delightful. Never would have said I needed that in my life, but I'm glad it's here now.
Yeah, and that was basically the gist of this last episode.
Is there anything else? There's one scene I really liked with Jake and Lexi, because Jake's actually this is probably the least Jake-centric episode we've had of the series so far. Mm-hmm. But he does have a side plot where he's like, you know what? Fuck it, I'm bailing from this town. He goes to a bus. He goes to a bus stop. Sees somebody carrying a good guy doll. Buys the good guy doll. Takes it over to Lexi, and Lexi's like, really? You're gonna fucking bail on all of us?
We're family.
We're family, you know, the found family thing, which I really like that whole thing. Like, Don Mancini and all of, the after episodes thing has been talking a lot about, how this show is very much about the queer experience, and I really like that little addition of, you're also including the found family thing. I really like that. That's a nice little thing that I'm surprised they haven't done, and it's also something that, again, time for a Christian fan theory, which probably means somebody's gonna die next episode and totally fuck this fan theory up, but considering everyone's parents are dead besides Lexi's, and let's be honest, probably Lexi's parents, or at least her mother's probably gonna die next episode.
Probably.
Don't know for sure, but more than likely.
Good stab in the dark.
Yeah. Assuming Andy lives after this series, I'm wondering if Andy's gonna adopt all the kids, but bring them along, and they're all gonna become Chucky hunters or something.
I'm kind of wondering that
because Don has specifically said he has two more movies in mind after this series that are gonna continue on after this.
We can't kill Andy. So if Andy's still alive,
and we still have all of the characters from Chucky, and I would like to keep these characters. I really like this cast of characters. That'd be a cool way to have them around, because most of them would probably end up in the foster system. Have Andy just fucking say, you know what, fuck it, let's just bail, guys.
He's stable.
Yeah, he's Okay, maybe have Kyle take them. She's stable and he's fun. But yeah, no, that's real good. Also,
he screams loudest with fire.
Yeah, I really like I like Alex Vincent's crazy adult Andy. That's a fun little facet of the character. But yeah, that was one thing I wanted to talk about. I can't think of anything else really though.
Okay, any final
fan theories or ideas of things we want to see happen at the end of the last episode?
I don't want Andy or Kyle dead.
I don't either. Although we're kind of setting it up, Randy.
No,
but Don also has been doing this a lot of playing with the audience's expectations. So maybe he's just really playing. Oh yeah, Andy's gonna die, and then
Andy better not die.
At the end, you know, like,
no, Andy and Kyle can't die. Everyone else fine. Fair game.
No.
I've been with these people much longer than these new people.
I guess that, but yeah.
I don't want them to die. Don't get me wrong, but I mean, if it came down to Andy and Kyle or one of the new kids, I haven't emotionally developed an attachment to you the way I have Andy and Kyle. I've been with Andy and Kyle. I grew up with them, literally.
Mm-hmm.
We're the same age, practically.
Yes, Kyle, the character who was in two.
Fuck you.
It was in one.
She saved Andy.
And a one scene.
You are not the person to call.
I know that. I'm just like, I like Kyle. I like, that's not a dig at Kyle. I'm just like,
yes, meatball
the great the great character who was in one movie and one scene.
And Eddie.
Eddie.
You missed Eddie.
Well, Eddie Caputo's dead. So whatever. that was one other thing I did like. We haven't talked about it, but every episode, the like Chucky logo is like made out of something new. This time it's made out of tombstones of all the characters that have died. A lot from this show, but also a bunch from the other movies. Like you see Eddie Caputo, you see I think Andy's mom in there, and I think officer fucking Dandridge from the first movie, which I think is the first official confirmation that those two are dead we've ever gotten. So yeah, that was fun.
Yeah, that is kind of cool that they're doing all that. But yeah, place your bets now, people, in the comments. I want to hear what your fan... How do you think the show's going to end? Who do you think's going to die? Do you think my fan theory is right that the teacher is probably Glenn or Glenda? Who's your money on? Because we always die. Someone always dies.
Yeah.
And the
is
finale
that, is
probably
anybody else
people.
Weirded out by by Jennifer Tilly telling Junior or his dad's favorite thing is Swedish meatballs? Am I the only one who that line kind of bugged them and was like, wait, what are we doing? Are we gonna like reveal that Junior's secretly Glenn and didn't know it or something?
That'd be cool.
I'd be down with it, and it would also kind of go with the whole queer experience thing again with the show, but like, are we gonna do that? What are we doing now? Again, I'm sure that's just a weird throwaway line, didn't mean anything, but that line bugged me. Well, not bugged me, but I was like, wait, what? That line fucked with me a little bit, so I want to know if anybody else had that.
He's basically like a rabbit with his ears perked up, and if next week's episode even mentions that a little bit, he's gonna go all fucking crazy
on
us.
Yeah, I know.
It's good, but definitely place your bets, people. Tell us your fan theories. Who do you think's gonna live? Who do you think's gonna die? And it better not be Andy or Kyle. That's all I'm saying.
I'm gonna be honest.
I'm gonna be pissed if it's Andy.
Like, I legit would. I kind of like the like I said. I kind of like the idea of like, oh, we'll kill Lexi's parents and then like her, Devin, and Jake, all even Junior, I guess too, because he's also an orphan. You might could redeem him, maybe. Maybe have like all of them be orphans and just Andy and Kyle take them, and maybe Nico as well, and they all just like go on the hunt for like more Chucky dolls or something. Like, that'd be kind of fun. I'd like that. That'd be a good setup for
or
sequels.
Or Junior go with Jennifer Tilly and Chucky.
Ooh, that would be maybe Junior, like Chucky jumps out of Nico's body and into Junior's. That'd be kind of cool.
That would be kind of cool. Well, leave your theories and thoughts and comments and who you think is going to live. Who do you want to live? Who do you want to die? I'll leave all those down in the comments below, and we'll all find out next Tuesday who's right, who's wrong. It's fun to play this game. I'm loving this show. Are you guys loving this show? Leave all thoughts, comments, and anything else you'd like to leave down in the thing below, and we will talk. And with all that out of the way, boos and ghouls, as always, we hope you've enjoyed this episode, and if you have and you're new around here, please hit that subscriber button, because we do appreciate every subscriber we get. And with that, we wish you a good day, a good evening.
Bye.
Bye, guys. See you next Tuesday.